Okay, it was Ivar who killed Margaret, because that.
Ships filled with treasure and slaves. I will come back.
Yep.
Let's go on.
Wow, the hostility just brewing between those two is... I like it, actually.
Margaret is dead. I know. Of course you know! You ordered this killing! But you could never get a woman pregnant.
Boy, playing with fire.
She is with my child.
That guy better pipe the hell down.
In any case.
Actually, no.
She was a crazy woman.
Pipe the hell up, because I want Ivar to, like, know.
You're stuck with me.
I like that little thing from Harold.
Bishop Cuthbert is dead. What? Cuthbert is dead. Murdered.
Murdered.
By?
By Lord Haymond.
What's gonna happen?
Murdering a servant of God in his own house.
He's still covered in blood,
and
too.
Still drenched in the martyr's blood, you come and defile this holy place, too.
Haymond shall be punished for his heinous crime.
That is not your decision, brother. For I am king, and I alone can make that determination.
I'm not sure your choice was wise, after all.
I miss you, Ecbert.
They whisper that I'm weak. I fear they are right.
You're gonna be great.
Is that all we can do? Pray?
No. There is something else that we can do.
Ube's gonna be the only one's gonna do it, right? Maybe.
Baptized in the Christian faith.
Yeah, not weird.
If we can appease his enemies, he will no longer.
What about Torvi and Lagan?
Harboring pagans.
Sometimes I wonder if you're ready to show the top.
He's probably the closest to him, so boy, shush. Safest thing to do would probably be kill him if I was in her position. I don't know what she's doing, though. Did I call it, or did I call it? Ew. Oh, wow!
I am risen from the dead. Then I was reborn.
Oh, yeah! I forgot that happened.
You're on this island.
Scrolls.
I feel like something's about to go wrong. They're holding this shot way too much. Like, the whole drinking thing, I feel like something's gonna go wrong. Maybe not.
Forgive me, my lady, but I cannot make the prospect sound any more attractive.
I have nothing to go back to, nor any wish to do so. If I were your wife, I would gladly share your dangers and tribulations.
But also because Beren's here.
I've decided to restore his grace, Bishop Hagman, to the bishopric of Sherborne.
Oh my god! Dude! He is just... He's such an interesting character, I can't. Like, this is crazy. Torvi, too! Oh!
Ragnar Lothbrok and his wife, Torvi, have agreed to be baptized into our Christian faith.
Wait, wife?
She's Catherine's daughter.
Wait, the one that just got murdered?
I renounce my belief in Odin and all other pagan gods.
Et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. In nomine Patre.
Jarl, listen. But don't expect to be in charge here for much longer. We have just been promised eternal life.
I don't feel any different. Do you?
Wow.
Do you, Alfred? Son of Aegon.
Shit, things are moving fast.
All these witnesses here gathered.
In nomine Patri.
Who's that?
It's Spiritus Sancti.
Who's the background dude?
Amen.
Amen.
Who's that? Wait, is that who I think it is? I don't want to, like, guess, you know, and it be wrong. But, like, Magnus? Question mark?
We share the same father.
I mean, not really.
Well, now, my brother. You are found.
I feel like this kid's gonna get killed. Oh, yeah, this... Oh my gosh, I forget that this happens. Bedding ceremony, I think it's what it's called.
You and I, together, will return in triumph to Kattegat.
To share our spoils with its king?
Yeah. No, we overthrow its king.
There it is.
We should always remember Ragnar Lothbrok.
Yes.
Even if we did not know him. Even if we only heard his name, and do you know why? Because we are all sons of Ragnar Lothbrok. All of us.
You're only here because of him.
That's why you are here. To help me fight against the devil.
If he doesn't end up betraying her, I'll feel betrayed. Because I'm like, I've been going into this thinking, oh, Hegman is 100% not on Lagertha's side. Ooh, conspiracy time, Aethelred. My goodness.
And then Freydis explained something to me. She told me that being deformed was a sure sign of the gods' favor. That it marked me out as a very special person.
I don't think
it wasn't a badge of shame after all.
Vidzirk is gonna believe that?
The fact is, Vidzirk, I for the boneless
is a god. Yeah.
He is a god. And I am carrying his divine child.
But it must be an important sacrifice. It must be someone that the gods will have heard of, someone that all the people will have heard of, some.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Bitch, that ain't happening. Oh my god, murder.
Is that answer enough?
I hope so. I like Harold, and I want him to succeed in what he wants to do. But I don't think he'll overthrow Ivar. What the hell happened?
She felt her time was near. She wanted to pray to Freya for a safe delivery. She wasn't there. I shouted, I looked for her. She disappeared.
Was it the evil guy? What was that?
King Egbert and his family betrayed me as they betrayed our father.
Mm-hmm. I think Beren knows that that ain't Ragnar's kid.
You're here to support King Alfred.
Sacrifice time! But it can't happen. Vidzirk can't die like this. Oh, he looks badass. They both look badass, even though I don't like her. What the hell is happening? My whole thing is, what's Freydis' endgame? Like, why Ivar? Why? So what's going on? Hey, I was just about to say, where's him? Where is he at? He just got woken up. Who is it? It can't be Vidzirk. Oh, they're gonna end it. Did they just end it? Oh, mother effer. Well, it's not Vidzirk. That's just too obvious, right? Then who is it? I can't think of anybody significant in Kattegat that would be under that cloak. Who would be significant? The only people there that are significant are Freydis, Ivar, Vidzirk. I don't think there's anybody else. Unless I'm missing someone very obvious that I'm forgetting, I don't think there's anybody else. Okay, that's interesting. So, okay. I don't know how to feel right. This episode's felt very long and then very short. So much happened in it that I'm just like, I feel like it got split into two parts, but I only just watched one episode. So Alfred and, oh, I already forget her name. Alfred and his wife are now married. The one who was with Bjorn. I think that's the only reason why she's like sticking around with Alfred is because of Bjorn. Also, we had a surprise return with Magnus this episode, who's going on pretending that he is Ragnar Lothbrok's son when he got told that he wasn't, and that's the reason why he got exiled. My whole question is, right, why, okay, does Bjorn know? Because I feel like with Bjorn's like knowing looks that he knows that Magnus isn't really Ragnar's son, but at the same time, how would you know for sure? I find it interesting how I am having a love for characters that I didn't really have a love for the last time I watched it. Last time I watched the show before this came back in November 28th was in August, I believe. And at that point, I think I was just binging it, and that's the whole like attitude of a binge. You don't really know when to get connected to certain characters because you don't know if they're just going to straight up die the next episode. But I have found that I have a connection with Harold, which is interesting because I really liked Halfdan. And literally, Harold killed his brother, which I hated when I watched it. But I find it interesting that I do have a connection with Harold because I do want him to succeed. I don't know who I like more, Harold versus Ivar. I think Ivar is just a bit unpredictable, and that's the best part about his character, is that he's unpredictable. But the thing right now is with Freydis, I don't like, because I consider Ivar the strongest character when it comes to just having motives and then going for it, but he hasn't really had a weakness so far. Besides the obvious is his legs, but I don't consider his legs a weakness. I consider them a strength, and that's exactly what Ragnar told Ivar, was like, you know, you don't think like other men. So I feel like Ivar has always been the strongest character, and I've never really found a weakness with him until Freydis. Freydis is the one that I'm just like, this is a weakness, and slowly draining the strength from Ivar unknowingly, I guess is a good way to put it, because Ivar, he believes he's on top of the world right now, but I'm not sure what the motivations of Freydis is. I really hope I'm pronouncing her name right. But, you know, because it's clear that she wants to get in his circle, wants to be queen and all that stuff. But why? What is she going to do? What does she want to accomplish once she gets what she wants? I mean, she literally got pregnant in order to do whatever she needs to do. So it's interesting. What else? We had Ube and Torvi get baptized this episode, and I was thinking, I was like, if any of the four are going to do it, it's probably going to be Ube. Torvi would have been my second guess, then Lagertha, then Bjorn. Bjorn would never do it because he believes full-heartedly in, you know, Odin and Thor and all that stuff, where I think Ube is very much like his father. So I saw someone comment, I think it was a comment on one of my videos, if not, then I saw this somewhere, but people have, you know, related Ivar's sons, like Ube, Ivar, and Bjorn. Vitserk is kind of a question mark for me right now. I don't really know how to, he needs to find his place, and I don't think he's found his place yet, but Ivar is more of the rage and savage side we've seen of Ragnar. Bjorn is definitely the explorer, you know, not curious. I wouldn't say Bjorn is curious. I think Ube is more of the curious son, but Bjorn is more of the explorer and wanting to see more, conquer more, do all that fun stuff. And then Ube is definitely the light of Ragnar, I think, and the curiosity and the accepting other people's beliefs, I think, in the good. I mean, he did get baptized, so yes, he of course has to. But it's very interesting, you know, especially when he took off his armoring. Even Athelstan, when he was going through his period of not really knowing what he follows, I don't think he took off his armoring until he had that revelation moment, BS, whatever. Until that moment. So the fact that Ube just took it off is very telling of, you know, his curiosity and his exploration. But yeah, so wait, there was something else. Oh, Floki. I've been trying to figure out if I like Floki's storyline or if I don't like Floki's storyline. Because it's one of those things where the lack of Floki that we're getting, I think, is starting to affect my love for the character. I will always love that character, but I'm forgetting why I do. Because we haven't really seen much of him, we haven't really heard much of him, and his storyline is, I don't hate it. I know I don't hate it. I don't know if I love it. I think I like it. That's where I'm at. It's kind of like watching I don't know. I'm trying to think of a storyline that I didn't really love, but I was fine with watching with Vikings. Probably like early season one stuff. You know what I mean? Some, like, when I wasn't that invested in certain characters, namely, like, maybe Rollo. I don't know. I'm trying to think of a storyline that's kind of, you know, what I'm feeling with Floki's storyline right now. But I'm afraid that if Floki were to die, would I, you know, lose that, would I lose all part of the show for me, or would I just lose someone in the show, if that makes any sense, because I just don't feel that connected to him as of late, which is very sad. I wish, I don't know, I don't know where he'd fit in with the main storyline stuff either, you know what I mean? I think with Ivar he'd find a place, but the same time with I really don't know where he'd fit in, so this is kind of perfect for him to have his own thing. I just don't know how to feel about it as of right now. But other than that, I don't know what else to talk about. I think I've talked about pretty much everything, except for the fact that Æthelred is going against Alfred, and I don't know. Because, well, Bishop Hegman has a pretty good idea that Æthelred is going to try to overthrow Alfred. My whole thing is, I'm wondering if Judith will know that. Well, no, she does, because he wants to marry the guy that Bishop Hegman killed, right? That's that person that's, you know, I'm not sure. Maybe if I misinterpret that, I'm not sure. But yeah, other than that, that's all for now. Thank you all for watching. If you want to see my previous reaction, all you have to do is click the link in the description. And as always, I will see you next time.